Hello everyone, my name is Harsh and I'm working as a trainer with Bigbenta Language School. And today this webinar is brought to you by Bigbenta Language School and with a short description. So Bigben is dealing into the foreign languages. We have 14 plus languages with us where you can train yourself and make a career out of it. Then it is dealing into the translation services. We majorly deal in the corporates. And we do provide the study abroad services. Study abroad services, like if you wanted to go to Canada, Australia, America, and several other countries. Other than this, we also do provide the services where you can formulate yourself and you can train yourself to clear the abroad examination like SAT, GRE, GMAT, IELTS, PTE, OET, and several others. So, in this webinar, we are going to talk about the business English. So when we talk about the business English, so the major factor what this business English talks about. Now, there are several major ways. There are several other major factors that we deal into. The most important thing in the business English is like how you communicate with your clients. And when it comes to the communication with the client, it represents yourself. It presents yourself, what you are, what you do, what you majorly deal into, what is the requirement of the client. So in this webinar, we are specifically going to talk about the presentation, which is just a module, or you can say it's a part of business English communication. So starting with the presentation part. So why presentation matters a lot? Because whatever you are presenting, according to that, the client or your customer is going to talk to you. So the presentation skills. What are the major factors? What are the major things? How you are going to deal with this? Now, the first thing in the presentation part is the content part. Content is God. What you are presenting, what your content is all about, what you are representing and what you wanted to communicate. So when we talk about the presentation skill, how to present. So the major thing is the content. Now, how to plan the presentation, preparing the presentation and delivering your presentation. So these three are the major and the most important factors when you are talking about or you are dealing while preparing a presentation. So first comes the planning, then the preparing, then the delivery of the presentation. First, planning the presentation. Now, when you plan the presentation, so what we are going to look at? Now, first thing is the need. Identifying the purpose, the major thing. Then understanding the audience and presentation structure and outline. Now, what is this identifying the purpose? And what is this understanding the audience? Let's suppose if you are presenting someone or you are presenting yourself in a school and the kids are, basically the audience are kids and you are presenting several images which are related to their subject. You are representing several videos which are related to the subject. Definitely, they are going to look after that. They are going to pay you the attention. They are going to pay you the attraction. You can see in their eyes that yes, they are paying the attention. But if you are going to present them about the business thing, or if you are going to talk about any foreign language, so maybe this may happen with you that they will not pay attention. Same goes to the business perspective. Let's suppose if your audience are between 30 to 35 years of age, they wanted to know about the growth. They wanted to know about the career. And if you are representing themselves something which is similar to a college boy or a college going guy, so they will not pay you a right kind of attention. One thing that is the purpose. If the need is not there, so they will not give you the proper attention. This thing you need to focus on. You need to understand the need. You need to understand the audience, what they want. After that, deliver it. Now, presentation structure and outline. What you need to represent, what should be the structure, what should be the content. Now we are going to deal about that. Identifying the purpose. Now, what are the types of information, these what you wanted to instruct, whether you wanted to entertain or else, whether whatever you have prepared is entertaining them or not, to persuade, to activate, or to inspire. These are the major things that you need to identify in your presentation while you are doing the presentation. It should be informative. It should inform someone. Instructions, if you are giving, it should be in a prestigious manner, in a positive way. It should be entertaining enough that a person who is listening to you should get entertained. Otherwise, if they are not getting entertained, then why they will pay you the attention, right? Now, another thing is to pursue, to activate something. Let's suppose I'm a person who is sitting in a seminar and somebody is presenting something and I'm not able to identify, or my strike point is not getting struck at a point. So I'll not pay you a kind of attention that you want. So our presentation, it should be in such a way that can activate, or that can pinch somewhere in our mind that can activate us to inspire or to motivate to do something, right, in this way. Now, coming on to the another one, understanding the audience, how many, who, and what is the need. The major factor is that the need. If somebody, let's suppose you are going to a seminar and if they are looking out for a simple English, and you are presenting themselves that what is the use of advanced English, the connection is not there. The connection is somewhere missing, because they want the English where they can strengthen their basics, not the advanced English. They need to strengthen their basics, then they need to go to the advanced, right? So therefore, do understand the need first. Now, how many will be there? This is a major goal. This is a major point. How many people? There are thousands of people in the seminar. There are hundreds as well. There are 10 as well. Who they are? Are they working professionals? Students? Teachers? Executives? Who they are actually? You need to understand them before preparing your presentation and your slides. Now, presentation structure and outline. So this is very major. You need to introduce that what it is going to talk about. You need to represent it in a very organized manner. You need to formulate every slide which can represent a kind of a knowledge. So the opening should be there. Then part A, part B, part C deals. That majorly means that whatever you have said, it is just a structure, or you can say the introduction. But part one, part two, part three, what are these? These are basically the depth knowledge that you are going to give to your audience, right? And then after that is the closing part. Whatever you have started, you need to finish that, right? So if you are going to finish that, finish it in a summarized manner. I hope I'm getting clear enough. Another thing, preparing the presentation. Now, how to prepare the presentation? Now, when you prepare your presentation, what are we going to look at? The first thing, content. As I already mentioned, the content is about visuals, formats, and layout. Why visuals? Because they attract, they entertain people. So do represent these all things, do amend these all things in your presentation part. Now, when we talk about step by step, the content part. So when we talk about the content, so these are the major things that we need to represent. The images, the introduction, the videos, the pictures, the graphs, which can represent the growth orientation, the improvement part, the basics, everything what a person needs, the facts, the logics, the motivation part, which is very, very important. If you are not getting me more motivated, so I don't think that people are going to pay you attention. Let's suppose for an example, let's take an example. If you have heard Narendra Modi, so he always motivates. I'm not going to talk about the facts or figures, whatever they are presenting, but he actually motivates people that yes, he shows the dreams. He's selling the dreams in an indirect way. So the same thing, this is how the fact, figures, content, pictures, and your motivation works out. Now, visual aids, how visual aid helps. Now, visual aids are a supplement to the presentation, not a substitute. You need to understand this. Don't show everything in a visual manner. Right? Don't show everything in an image or with a picture, or you can say by a kind of gesture or something like a video. Prepare the content, implement that, and along with that, do show the images which can attract people and which can show the right kind of the guidance to them. The next one. Use them to make important points. Put one major idea on each slide. Charts must be large. Proof, read them very, very carefully. So this is the very major factor. Now, when we talk about the presentation part, so people do focus on the logical points, the facts that you are representing them, the figures, the dates, places, the actual or the right kind of the planning or forecasting. So do represent them in a very streamlined manner. Do represent them in a systematic manner. Use the points, use the major idea, represent the facts and figures in this way. Now, formats and layout. How this format and layout will help you out. What to keep in mind when preparing your slides? Now, it is imperative that one attempts to restrict the complexity of the language utilized to convey one's ideas, lest the audience is bewildered by the ramification of the expression. Did you understand that? Is it a simple English or an advanced English? Keep it simple. People should be able to understand your language. Don't use a wide range of vocabulary which is not appropriately, it is not properly mentioned or which is not appropriate to people, those who are there in the audience. Represent it in such a way that everybody is able to understand in ease. Use a proper understandable language. No clutter in terms of color, content, or design. Your design should be proper. It should not look like a rainbow, right? So many mixture of colors and everything, right? It should be in a proper way. Simple and sober, looks great. Clear, readable format. If somebody is not able to read, then how he will be able to understand what you are conveying them? So the major part is that everything should be readable enough that a person can read that. No diversion, too many animation, it should not be there. So many animation will make it like a movie, so nobody is looking after what kind of movies you are making or what kind of thing you are representing them. It should be very simple, logical, crisp, and clear information should be there. No more than 6 points per slide. See, if you are reading a book, there are so many pages in a book. And when you read a book, there are so many lines, right? But when you are representing something, you are representing a slide, and when you represent a slide, don't make it so hodgepodge. Make it simple. 5, 4, 6 facts are more than enough. Because you need to tell them according to, okay, so according to this slide, there are 6 points. This is how I'm going to deliver. This is how I'm going to make them understand what these 6 points will deal about. More than 6 points, 7.8, 10, 11, 12. That means you need to compromise on the font size. You need to compromise on the content. You need to compromise on the pages of the entire pages of the slides, the entire presentation. So these are the major facts. Now, format and layout, the rules. Use up to a maximum of 2 fonts, not more than that. Use a minimum of 3 different colors in one slide. As I already mentioned, don't make it a rainbow. It is best to use paragraphs on your slides. Don't make it in such a way like sentence by sentence, sentence by sentence. No, there are connectors as well. You can use the connector like moreover, therefore, however, these all things. Each slide must focus on at least 3 major ideas. Idea what we learned that there should be only 6 or less than 6 points in a slide. Why? Because you need to focus on each and every point. If you are diverted with so many points, then the audience will not be able to understand what kind of thing or what kind of knowledge you wanted to give them on that particular slide. So therefore, please do focus on major and clear ideas. Each slide should have no more than 4 to 5 bullet points. Now let's understand this with an example. So let's suppose, I hope everybody is having WhatsApp and they are using it. So in the morning, you will always get like, good morning, this and that, this and that. A big format, nobody cares. But if I text you within 3 lines, if I text you within 2 lines, so definitely you are going to read that. Hope I'm not wrong. This happens with every person. So these are the major factors, actually. So therefore, very crisp and content, very crisp content, only major points. Bullet points, just mention, because they need to get the crisp ideas, what you are going to talk about. Now, what is the best to avoid in a presentation? Now, coming on to the English. Do you think English is distracting? See, in the normal world, everybody speaks English. But when you talk about the corporate, a different kind of English you may say. Let's suppose, take an example. I wanted to know, I wanted to inquire, I wanted to interrogate. The meaning is same. They are asking about the information. I wanted to know. Looks like very simple. I wanted to interrogate. Interrogate is considered as a bad word. Why? Because it is talking about an interrogation where you want the ideas or the knowledge in a depth. I wanted to inquire. Looks like pleasant enough. So therefore, use these kind of words. Now, this is how and this is why business English is very, very major and important. Now, bad color choices. Avoid loud colors like yellowish, because they actually hurt your retina. Dark text on light background is the best. It looks very simple and clear. Avoid text colors that fade into background blue and black. Avoid color blind combination. Well, what is color blind? Basically, let's suppose the background is red and you are writing in a green. So it looks like it is not appropriate enough. Blue and yellowish, these kind of colors. Now, here we go. Now, what are the major things? when you talk about a particular language or anything. The major thing is listening, reading, writing, speaking, these all. Now, coming on to the another practice, overwhelming pictures. Use picture, but don't let them use you. Some people use different kind of pictures, and pictures, when they use, they represent everything. So that this point actually means that you don't have to use these kind of pictures that may use you. You are the one, you are the authority who is representing. You are the one who is going to explain. So don't use a kind of a picture which don't actually need your support to represent or to deliver your idea. Now, keep slides simple. Too much diverts audience away from the content. Don't keep too much of slides. Simple, sober, logical, factual, and actual. Too many pictures also make saving a presentation difficult. Don't use, as I have already mentioned, don't use so many pictures or so many things. Now, step 3, delivering the presentation. Now, it will talk about the presentation part, how you represent, what it is, what you need to deliver, these all things. Delivering your presentation, what are we going to look at? Now, your voice, your body language, your grooming, delivering don'ts and do's, your voice, your pitch, which is going to actually help you out, the body language which you are going to represent, the eye contact which you are going to make it very stunning, very simple and attractive with everybody, with the audience. Now, body language. Smiling, which represents a friendly behavior. Nodding, attentive and alert. Eye contact, confident and focused. Now, body language, other things are crossed arms, defensive, fidgeting hands or tapping feet, nervous or bold, lack of eye contact, untrustworthy. So these are actually the things which affects. Other things are the way you communicate, the way you represent your body posture. Proper posture conveys confidence, authority. Let your audience know you are in charge. You are the one who is representing. You want to connect them. Now, style, the actions and gestures, which is very, very important. Stand or sit, walk around or not. Eye contact, maintaining eye contact, individual, that means using a T-zone. T-zone means left, right, and front. Left, right, and front, the T-zone. Dividing the room into two sections and maintaining the eye contact. Try to maintain the eye contact on every person. Don't make it in a simple or make it in such a way that you are focusing just on a one person. Vary the pitch and tempo. Not too fast, not too slow. So you need to maintain a pitch that you don't have to go too fast and you don't have to go too slow. It should be very simple, energetic, attractive enough. Be wary of fillers like these all, the sound, it actually affects. Now, the phrasal verbs, the pronunciation, stressing on a word, or you can say stretching the word, pauses and silence. These all things actually make an effect where you can check your audience whether they are paying the attention or not. Grooming, it is very simple. If you look good, you feel good, and if you feel good, you do good. What to wear? The major point. Now, just look at these images. So I hope you will understand by these images that which one is important or not. I think the fourth image is effective enough, and it is in the proper manner where you can represent yourself in a formal way. Now, how to speak, breathe, articulate, use pauses, emphasize, and check your volume. Delivery, how to deliver, to read notes or not. This is also a very important point. Now, see, play with the confidence card. What is this confidence card? We'll be talking about this. Now, confidence card. Distribute the papers. Whenever you feel like you wanted to take a pause, or you wanted to stop, or you wanted to, you know, take a breath, do the activities. It is also major. It helps you in engaging. Rewind and recap. Now, what does this rewind and recap means? You are repeating the points which are very important. There are a few negative points and positive points. So when you talk about the positive points, you need to focus on them majorly. You need to raise your voice at that time. And when you talk about the negative points, that you can deliver it in a slow manner, or making your voice in a very, or you can use a very slow pitch. Right? Using a slow pitch can help you out a lot. Another way, multicolored slides look attractive, but please do focus that don't make it a rainbow. It's okay to use language and your slide. After all, everybody knows it. So I think it is not properly written, but again, you are able to understand. It can also help you in attracting. Video clips and images make presentation interesting. Yes, of course. These things actually make your presentation interactive. Lot of information, paragraphs should be displayed on the slides. Complex sentences, language make a great impression on the audience, but not too much. Again, not too much. One should dress keeping the audience in mind. What kind of audience you are having? Look at yourself in a mirror. What do you need to become a good presenter? Now, we are coming to an end by this. It boils down to, if you can see the image, just focus on this, the language and communication. You have a lot of many things to represent. But let's suppose you have kept water in your in a bowl, and then you are boiling it. After the evaporation process, you will get up. Then you will calculate the amount of water that you have. It is the pure water. And the waste is actually removed. So in the same way, the language and the communication works. It will crisp you out. Now here, Big Ben is going to help you out to represent yourself, or to get a command on a language. And we are going to help you out to communicate in a well-mannered in the corporate culture by building your language, your communication skills, your confidence level, everything. So this was all about the presentation part and the presentation skill. With the another webinar, we'll be coming out with another kind of a skill, because we have in the business English, we have a lot of things like negotiation, team building, team management, etc. and etc. So coming to an end, along with this presentation, last but not the least, of course, several people will be having doubts and queries. So I'll recommend them to just log on to www.bblanguages.com, or you can call us and you can take any help. We got a team who is going to help you out whether you wanted to inquire for the business language, for corporate skills, if you wanted to train your enterprise, we can help you out in the translation part as well, and many more things. I hope that this was a very informative session for you, and we'll meet you again with the another kind of a module. And thank you so much for being a nice audience, and just help us with your feedback, and again, so that we can work out on that and we can connect you again in a very prestigious way and a manner. I hope this webinar was informative for you. And if you have any query, you can contact us directly, or you can mail us as well on helpline@bblanguages.com. Thank you so much for being a nice audience for us. Thank you, everyone. Have a great day.